Hello everyone, myself Arnav Goswami from IIT Madras India. I'll be talking about high extinction palm rejection filters that play a very important role in silicon quantum photonic devices. At first, I'll go through the motivation and discuss about distributed drag reflector as filter. Then our DBR design and fabrication will be explained. Finally, I'll concentrate on the performance of the filters and the stimulated 4M emission part. Due to CMOS compatibility, scalability, and high nonlinearity of silicon, integrated quantum silicon photonics has seen rapid development over the last 5 and 6 years in many quantum applications like key distribution, teleportation, photonic computation. In 2016, Silverstein et al. Has proposed how the architecture of a large-scale quantum silicon photonics chip will look like based on these functionalities. Now, all quantum applications need some kind of source for single photons or entangled photon pairs. In general, in silicon, chi2 equals to zero, so people rely on spontaneous 4M mixing based on chi3, where if you launch a high input palm power into a long straight waveguide or a compact spiral waveguide, entangled photon pairs, signal and Idler will be generated based on this energy and the momentum conservation. Now, to reduce the requirement of the input palm power level, ring resonator is an obvious choice because in resonance condition inside the ring cavity, there will be a large buildup of optical intensity. This is the typical transfer function of a 20 micro ring resonator. So if you launch palm into its one of its resonances, signal and Idler will be generated at the other resonances symmetrically placed from the palm resonance. But we are exploiting the chi3 nonlinearity. So the requirement of palm power is still very high. So the actual power level depends on the source design. Still the residual palm power is approximately 10 to the power 9 times greater than the power of generated signal or Idler. So if you want to manipulate the quantum states of signal and Idler on chip, you have to suppress the high intense palm after the generation by a high extinction palm removal filters. Though people have been demonstrating good quality photon source over the last few years, but still the desired on chip high extinction filters are not really available at this moment. People are trying to achieve in different ways. Though there are other options for on-chip filtering, distributed drag grating is a preferable choice due to its relatively easier design and effector-free nature. We expect that extensions will be greater than 100 dB with a bandwidth narrow enough around the palm wavelength, and it should have negligible backscattering. Therefore, if you combine the palm rejection filter along with the source at the output, you will get photon pairs without the palm. So any subsequent operation on the quantum states of signal and Idler can be done on chip with minimum background noise. This is the simple top view of a distributed drag reflector where there is a reflection and transmission. So here is a periodic perturbation of the refractive index in the propagation direction. In the transmission, a range of wavelength around this drag wavelength will be rejected, and that will come as a reflection in the input side, and the rejection of this drag volume depend as 10 hyperbole square kappa LG, where LG is the length of the grating. So if you increase the length of the grating as high, then you can achieve high extinction. But in theory, in practice, the smallest fabrication error that accumulates over the length, and therefore your extinction ratio will be saturated. So basically, you cannot have high extinction just by increasing the length of the DBR or cascading this type of many DBRs. Recently, Osar et al. Has shown high quality entanglement from a ring resonator by integrating 4 stages DBR with it. This is their DBR design, where input waveguide is fundamental modded. So if you launch TE0 in the DBR with a special design, it will be converting back into TE1, but that TE1 will not come into the input because it supports only TE0. So the reflection from each stage is not passing through any of the previous stages. As a result, you can cascade many of the individual stages. This is their transfer function of overall devices, and they have achieved a palm rejection greater than 60 dB with a 3 dB bandwidth of 5.5 nanometer, and their insertion loss is just greater than 2 dB. But now the problem associated with the single stage filter is that even if you increase the length of this filter after 300 micron, the extinction ratio is being saturated around 40 dB. So you need to cascade these 4 stages. Now, if we can increase the extinction ratio of a single stage filter within the same principle so that we can cascade many stages, so we have to cascade less number of filters, and that will be a great advantage. In 2017, our group had demonstrated band rejection filter based on single side wall DBR in a multimode waveguide. This is the top view of the design, where in the input is fundamental mode and in the DBR region it supports fundamental as well as the first order mode. So the in the reflection band there will be two bands. First one is corresponding to the fundamental mode propagating in the backward direction, and this is due to the first order mode propagating in the backward direction. But this lambda B01 will not come into the input because it supports only the fundamental mode. Now we want to go with this design for on-chip power filtering around this band, because this band will not come into the input, so that in later stage we can cascade many individual stages. Now we have kept slab of around 150 nanometers such that the refractive index contrast in the horizontal direction reduced, and it basically helps to achieve high rejection. If you see, for h equals 150 nanometer and T0 and T1 exist for a waveguide width in between 600 nanometer to 1300 nanometer, and for a grating period of 290 nanometer, this is the calculated Bragg wavelength. But this lambda B00 and lambda B01 are separated by 35 nanometer to 40 nanometer, so that we can safely use this band for pump filtering. This is the corresponding rejection and the bandwidth according to these two bands, and these are the coupling coefficients. As we are interested in kappa 01, it is due to the coupling between fundamental mode and the first order mode, and this integration has been taken in the perturbation region. Now the coupling depends on the type of perturbation. We are interested in two types of perturbation: sinusoidal grating and the rectangular grating. Though the coupled mode theory is for weak perturbation, still we have seen how this coupling coefficient varies for up to a strong perturbation for a waveguide width of 1 micron, and we have seen that for sinusoidal this coupling coefficient is more. But if we increase the coupling coefficient, the bandwidth is also increasing. So there is a trade-off in designing that what type of perturbation and what kind of modulation you will be choosing. So we decided to have 450 micron long DBR of these two perturbation, sinusoidal and rectangular, and we have kept a 10 micron taper such that there should be a smoother transition from the fundamental mode into the DBR region, and we have used grating coupler for light coupling in or out. These devices have been fabricated in a single step, patterning by electron lithography and followed by dry etching in ICPRI. These are the zoom same image of the DBR region. These two grating have been fabricated in two different devices. So the waveguide width is same, but it has a more perturbation of 350 nanometer with a duty cycle of 0.7, where here the perturbation is less, 120 nanometer, with a duty cycle of 0.5. Now this is our characterization scheme, and we had fabricated a long straight waveguide along with the DBR to see the wavelength dependency of the grating coupler. And our grating coupler is optimized with vertically 10 degree angle for T polarization. These are the transmission characteristics for two different gratings for a -6 dBm input power launched from tunable laser source. Now for rectangular modulation, though the extinction ratio is greater than 50 dB, but bandwidth is not narrow. It's quite big, around 70 nanometer, and these lower wavelengths coupled to the radiating mode. Whereas for sinusoidal grating, the top bandwidth is around 7 nanometer, and if you zoom it here, extinction ratio is greater than 55 dB. And for these two grating, the insertion loss is within 1 dB. We have checked the performance of sinusoidal grating modulation in presence of high power. So we amplified a laser and we kept it in the pass band, in the stop band, and we have achieved a maximum extension of 60 dB by varying the laser wavelength around the Bragg wavelength. We noticed that extension ratio remains greater than 56 dB for 800 picometer bandwidth. Finally, we have done the stimulated four-way mixing experiment, where we have amplified the signal along with the pump and for the sinusoidal grating devices. And we kept initially the signal and the pump in the pass band, and we have seen the generation of idler and the conjugated idler also, as we have not used any filter after this EDFA. AC noise is seen in the spectrum. These are the estimated launch power that are quite high. Now when you change this pump wavelength into the stop band, pump is reduced by 58 dB, but still there is a generation of idler. That is due to that 1.2 millimeter long straight waveguide section is there just before the grating, and this wavelength separation also reduced. Here this palm and idler is separated by 58.6 dB, but in this case this power difference reduced to minus 12.5 dB. So in general, this sinusoidal grating is capable of suppressing the palm while preserving the signal and idler. So we can expect, if you cascade only two types of this sinusoidal grating, we can expect a maximum extinction greater than 100 dB. So in summary, we have addressed the high extinction palm rejection filter that are very important for integrated silicon quantum photonics, and for that purpose single sidewall DBR in a multimode waveguide is a suitable candidate. And in our case, sinusoidal grating performs better than the rectangular modulation, and with sinusoidal grating we have obtained a palm rejection of maximum 60 dB, and we have shown the stimulated 4-mxing experimental result and shown that palm is being really rejected. As a future scope, we want to check whether we can still increase the extinction ratio of sinusoidal DBR grating by optimizing the waveguide parameters, and we want to cascade in many stages and want to check how the extinction ratio is scaling. And finally, we want to integrate it with microring resonator for spontaneous 4-mxing experiment and subsequent entanglement measurement. At last, I want to thank Department and Science Technology Department, Government of India, for funding this project. Thank you.